Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Tony D'Angelo here, and welcome to my home. I'm having a tough time keeping a straight face here today because I got an email from a viewer asking what to feed to children. You know, what can I feed my nieces and nephews when they come over? What can I feed kids? And I never had any children. I never got married. So I called up an old girlfriend of mine who's got a big family now. And I asked her, I said, hey, what do you feed children? And there's this long pause on the phone. And she said, Anthony, they're just smaller people. You can feed them pretty much anything you can eat. I think she was expecting something like, you know, fish food or something, or like, you know, what do you feed a goat? And I had to laugh. I said, no. I said, what can you feed them that they'll accept? What's a good thing to feed them that's not bad for them? And we both laughed. And she said, well, you know, think back to when you were a child, if you ever were a child, and what was your favorite food? And I pretty much ate anything. And her reply was, you know, macaroni and cheese is good. Grilled cheese sandwiches are good. All kinds of stuff. So today on Cooking for Men, we are going to show you how to make a deluxe grilled cheese sandwich. Maybe it wasn't that funny, but I was chuckling about it. Anyways, let's take a quick look at our ingredients. Okay guys, what we got here are two thick slices of, we like to make it a little bit special, so we're using the homemade bread. We're going to use some margarine. This is a smart balance. Very good tip is to let this sit out a little bit and get softened up. And we have about 3 or 4 slices of Kraft American cheese. What you want to do here is you want to butter one side of the bread. You don't want to be sparing with the margarine or butter. You want to make sure you get everything a good coat. That's going to give us our nice crunchy grilled cheese. This is not exactly health food. It's, I think you could call it comfort food. But once in a while, what the heck, right? Okay, now. You want to use enough cheese to completely cover the unbuttered side of your bread. Take your time with it. You get good results. I'm just going to put a little extra in there because I already took the plastic off it. Let's go over to our grill. Okay. When I'm cooking one of these, I prefer to use a 5-inch cast iron skillet. But for the purposes of the video here, we're going to use the flat griddle. These things are great. You can pick them up anywhere for about $20. Okay, we're using our kitchen timer. And we set it for 3 minutes. And we're going to take our grilled cheese. Lay it on there for 3 minutes per side. We've got the temperature on this set to 350 degrees Fahrenheit. I'm still chuckling about that comment. They're just little people. You can feed them anything. She had visions of me walking through a supermarket looking for a box marked children's food. Okay, there's our timer. For another three. Now we're using, it's a Teflon cook surface, so we're using a plastic spatula. You tell me that's not beautiful. Now, a lot of you will ask, why use a timer on something this simple? Well, the answer is it makes it a lot easier for you. All your sandwiches will come out consistent. And if you get distracted, you know, you don't have to flip it over, look at it, flip it back over the other way. It's a real helpful little tip. And look at that, that's beautiful. Oh, there we go. Stop our timer. Unplug our cooktop. Always have your plate ready. Right on there. Now, for some reason, they always cut these on a bias like that. I think it's a law. But we'll just give it a slice. Mmm, that's good. My personal favorite is to eat this with a bowl of tomato soup. Yum. Well, there you have it, guys. Now you can make a deluxe grilled cheese sandwich. We call it deluxe because we used a thick homemade bread. I'm still laughing about my friend's comment and that misunderstanding, but it's all in good fun. If we get some more requests for some food for children, we'll cook some more. If not, we'll just keep moving right down the list. God bless each and every one of you. Thank you all for watching. We can't thank the viewers and the subscribers enough. Without you guys, we wouldn't be here. We know that and we appreciate that. Thank you all. God bless you all. And remember, even tough guys can cook.